So next week could be the end of the Mueller probe, or at least the end of the beginning. Why do I say that? Well, there are unknowns. What is and is not in it? What are you allowed to know about? What else might Mueller still be pursuing? What might Congress do after it learns of Mueller's decisions? But here's what we know for sure. This is going to be an especially chaotic time. This president will be under pressure, in all likelihood, like he's never been before. Not because he's going to be removed in cuffs, but because almost certainly he's not going to like things in the report. And we know when he's under pressure, he lashes out. If past behavior is any indicator, the president has a number of go-to tactics to obfuscate the facts or downplay the importance of the report. Here's one tactic. Mislead.
Everybody tells me I'm not under investigation. Maybe Hillary is. I don't know, but I'm not.
All right, you know, you hear that? Change the subject, make it about somebody else. Tactic two, move the goalposts. Remember what Trump was saying just 2 years ago.
Can you say whether you are aware that anyone who advised your campaign had contacts with Russia during the course of the election?
Well, I told you, General Flynn obviously was dealing, so that's one person, but he was dealing as he should have been.
During the election?
No, nobody that I know of. Nobody.
So you're not aware of any contacts during the course of the election?
How many times do I have to answer this question?
Can you just say
Russia is a ruse.
All right. And here's what the president's lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, said just last month.
I never said there was no collusion between the campaign or between people in the campaign.
Yes, you
have. I have no idea if I have not. I said the president of the United States.
All right. Distraction. Tactic number three. Attack the investigators and political rivals.
It's a total witch hunt.
It's a Democrat hoax.
They have this witch hunt.
That was a Democrat hoax.
It's a witch hunt.
Phony witch hunt.
It was a hoax.
It's like a witch hunt. It's like a witch hunt.
This is a hoax. The witch hunt continues.
And then there's the signature trait, which is to abuse the truth and any who are trying to get it, namely the media.
It's fake news. It's fake. I'm telling you, it's just fake news.
And I read it this morning. It's a lot of fake news.
Well, that's total fake news.
Did you fire Robert Mueller? What if fire Robert Mueller?
Fake news, folks. Fake news.
So if the probe does end next week, if there's a surprisingly comprehensive report that the DOJ releases to the public, that's good. But get ready. A storm is coming. Expect the president and his allies to throw everything they have at you to make as much noise as possible to distract and obfuscate. And expect those who seek advantage in any negative information to spin it fast and hard as well. You're going to have to be on guard for left and right and remain reasonable. All right. Many involved have a desired outcome. So keep your focus on facts. If you get a feel for what did and did not happen and why, and I promise you, we will do our best to help you get any information that we can. In that case, any conclusions will be your own.